Money is important for artists. However, money can be foreign to the process of creating art. Commodifying your skill might seem gross, but it's essential for the system we exist in. In this society, money is the fuel for choices. And in this video, we're going to discuss how to price your art with various clients and how to negotiate for the rate you deserve. Some of our viewers, you know, they're like teenagers and they're drawing on their phones and they're doing work for like maybe their mom's friends or something.
And some of them are just out of college and they're doing professional freelance with professional software and they need a good idea of a freelance rate.
And a small few of you might actually be applying to animation studios and you guys need to know what rate to say to a producer. You need to know what the union minimum is and you need to know how weekly pay works in animation. Now, how much should you actually charge for your art? To decide this, you must first begin by understanding your client. Not all clients can actually pay well. A small ad agency in the middle of America that does occasional print design work will not be able to pay as much as a motion graphic studio in Santa Monica.
Here are a couple things to consider before choosing a good price. Charge hourly. The most important tool that you can use to protect yourself from the client and protect the client from you. By charging hourly, you can avoid doing batch work. For example, doing 5 character illustrations for $350 might seem reasonable to a young artist, but what if each character takes you 8 hours? Now you're actually working for $8.75 an hour.
Estimate work time. It's very important to give reasonable estimates for the time spent, and you may have to start guessing at first, but soon you're going to have a rough idea of how long something takes. By charging hourly and estimating the time spent on some work, you can come to an agreement with your client much easier.
Consider the different types of artwork needed to complete a project. If your client is expecting you to do illustration and typography, these are technically 2 different jobs, and graphic design is actually quite hard.
And really inform the client of what these different things are, because an educated client is much easier to work with.
When pricing your artwork, consider your expenses, your computer hardware, your drawing supplies, your education, and your lifetime spent learning this craft. Never sell yourself short, because the client is actually paying for your art and your experience.
Yeah, and I've got 25 years of experience. No, 30 years. I'm 30 years old. Oh man, this game is a long game.
Here's the per hour BAM Animation recommended prices for your artwork in 2019.
So if you're just a teenager, maybe you're like drawing on your phone for like your mom's friend, I mean, go with a reasonable price. I would say maybe $15 an hour. It's above minimum wage. You can definitely make some money doing that.
And if you're fresh from school and you're working on professional software, I would say about $25 an hour is actually a low rate. It might seem high, but it's important to charge that amount.
Yeah, and you're worth it because you're using all the tools. Now, if you're a professional,
like us,
yeah, really experienced, we're definitely talking $40 and above.
Not doctor money, but medical assistant money for sure.
That's a much more livable rate, especially in a city like LA.
Oh, God.
So just so you know, guys, with this video, we're trying something different. We kind of just wrote a script that was important to us, and we just wanted to read it to you without a lot of editing so we could kind of get like just a filler video out there, but a filler video with really good information.
Yeah, I mean, this channel comes from frustration of us looking up other videos on YouTube, and there's just no good negotiation videos. So I really, really wanted to put out simple negotiation rules. Okay, so number one, always negotiate. Big companies like movie studios or advertising agencies or even animation studios have some person who deals with money. You must negotiate with them. These people take classes and they get degrees to prepare for business.
They want to spend the least money possible for the best results. Asking for more money is customary and it's expected. It's not rude. In fact, it's dumb not to ask. So always, always negotiate. Rule number two, say the first number.
If somebody asks you to do a job, graciously respond, thanking them, and immediately name your rate. Name the number that is higher than the number that you would like. Even if it seems ridiculous to you, the producer will know that you're not messing around.
When negotiating, the person spending money is going to aim low. So the person receiving money, you, should aim high. The number you land on will be a number in the middle, and that's a compromise between your two preferred prices. Statistically, the first number said will be closer to the compromise price.
Rule number three, don't flinch, AKA never negotiate with yourself.
Once you've named a price, a producer will normally respond with something like, we aren't capable of paying that. This is a test on their end to see if you flinch.
This is some Sun Tzu Art of War shit.
An amateur negotiator will get frightened and like lower the price immediately, but a professional will stay solid and respond with a matter-of-fact attitude like, that's unfortunate, but this is my preferred rate.
The negotiation game is a game of tennis. It's a number in exchange for a number. If they don't give you their preferred price, you need to ask for it, as opposed to lowering your own out of fear. This tennis match will continue back and forth until you can both agree on a compromise rate. I prefer negotiation via email so that you have the numbers and agreement in writing. These negotiation rules are universal for all types of negotiation, and you should practice negotiation for small things in appropriate places, like when signing up for a new phone or internet company, buying merch at a con, if you're at a flea market.
Important tip, guys, professional artists take themselves seriously, and it's important to discuss your rate of pay with other artists. This is gonna help the industry as a whole. And in some cultures, it's considered rude to discuss how much money you make, but the only person this type of secrecy benefits is the producer. Like, if someone's making a lot less than you, and they're doing the same job, that's a problem, and they need to know that they're getting taken advantage of so that the next time they go to negotiate, they can ask for a reasonable rate of pay, the same rate that you're getting.
So what if I tell a client that this job is going to take me 10 hours and I complete the job in 8 hours?
Oh, okay, so it's 2 hours less than what you said?
Yeah.
Well, that's pretty close, and you've already kind of agreed on a price. And I think in something like that, you might want to consider, like, you've also invested all this upfront money into like your setup, like your computer and your tablet and all this stuff. And I would probably just charge the 10 hours. I mean, I wouldn't like rip off your clients at all, but something that's very close like that, I mean, you have to think about yourself and what you're worth.
But you should keep track of your hours and make a better estimate next time.
Let's talk about weekly rates. Weekly rates are great for production studios because they expect you to work 40 hours.
So a lot of studios will negotiate with a weekly rate, not an hourly rate.
Yeah, yeah. When you reach the big time and you're working at a studio, you're going to be talking about a weekly rate. That's more of a union thing and more of a standardized work week. And for that, we've linked the local 839 Los Angeles Animation Union average pay rate below. So let's talk about online commissions. And here's a really simple tip. Don't just sell unlimited online commissions because you could get really overwhelmed. My advice would be to set up a slot system, make 10 slots that people sign up for. And that way you're doing a limited number of drawings.
This is the concept of scarcity as well. It's why they put clothes on sale. You have a limited time to buy something, so you're more likely to buy it.
Yeah, it really makes your art more valuable.
And lastly, art is a viable resource and a craft that many people cannot do. It deserves high respect. So don't take on any projects that pay in exposure or experience. Accepting work like that devalues all of our collective worth. So make sure that you get paid, motherfucker. This shit has value. It's hard.
Well, the clients just don't understand what the art you're doing is. They think it's kind of like magic.
Yeah, and they think it's magic and they think it's easy.
And they think you're doing it for fun because this is what you enjoy doing. Like when you get your oil changed, the car mechanic isn't changing your oil for fun. Like he's getting paid per hour. And realistically, what we're doing is very similar.
So to help you, we've attached a couple sample invoices that me and Brent actually use. An invoice is a bill that you give to your client. So we've got PSDs and Word documents of real invoices so that you can use them for your own freelance.
You want to build a sense of professionalism around the experience of working with you because you are a professional artist. You're a sole proprietorship. That's how you're going to do your taxes. And you want the client to feel like they're working with a professional.
So download them below. And thanks for watching.
We hope that this was helpful. You know, it's a new format for us, so just, I don't know, let us know what you think.
Yeah, what would you like us to discuss?
Because we could discuss anything on this channel, and we have a lot of information that it doesn't necessarily justify like a whole BAM video, but it would be fun just to talk about on camera.
What I would like to discuss is that little neckerchief.
My pocket square. Oh, wow. That's called a pocket square, Max, and if you had any class, you would definitely have one.
Cut the tape.